For the 16th installment of Famicom Adventures, let's check out Route 16 Turbo. In my opinion, Easy has the best music by far, which gives me a good excuse to play in that mode. Still so challenging after the first couple stages that I have no idea how to survive. In Route 16 Turbo, I mean. Though, I don't know how to survive IRL either. Route 16 Turbo is an enhanced conversion of an arcade game, Route 16, a 1981 title from Tekken and Sunsoft. Turbo features superior graphics and much better music. The player controls this turquoise sports car, blasting through maze-like rooms called routes. Each route has at least one exit. When the player drives in the halls between these walled routes, the camera zooms out, showing a radar view of the whole level. Each level features 16 routes, thus the title. Route 16 could also allude to Nagoya Expressway Route 16, an expressway in Aichi Prefecture, where Sunsoft is headquartered, or Japan National Route 16, a highway that loops around Tokyo, where Tekken operated. Perhaps the title refers to both, representing the union between the two companies that birthed the arcade title. In any case, the arena depicted here doesn't resemble either Route 16. Enemy cars represented by green dots on the radar also roam these streets, aiming to smash into your car and destroy it. Their cars are clearly much stronger than yours, emerging unscathed. Other enemies that never leave their routes include various sorts of monsters, some terrifyingly represented by only black footprints, similar to the overworld enemies in Esper Dream. In the zoomed out view, a number is displayed on each route. I have no clue what the numbers mean. Some mystery science will never solve. The route layouts can be quite tricky. Sure, from a map, that route looks like it has multiple exits, but it turns out the exits do not connect to each other, dividing the route into several mutually inaccessible rooms. Some routes contain tunnel entrances that act as warp points to tunnel entrances in other routes. These are particularly handy for shaking off pursuers. The player can also speed up using turbo, an essential skill to survive the competition. The constantly dwindling fuel gauge only affects turbo. Somehow our car will run fine on an empty tank, just without turbo boost abilities. The player's objective is to collect all the treasures whose icons blink on the radar screen. Finding them all clears the level. Then onward to the next set of 16 routes. Some treasures periodically alternate between being treasures and being oil slicks. Clearly commentary on how the difference between treasure and garbage is only cultural context. Picking up the oil slick contributes to level completion, but it slows you down and adds no points to your score. Especially in later levels, slowing down is a death sentence. Other treasures appear as a question mark and then a bomb until the player drives over the correct item or button or whatever those are to defuse it. The bombs kill in one blow. I might have spoken too soon when calling the oil slick a death sentence. Some treasures aren't necessary to complete the level, goodies hidden in routes only to raise the player's score, like in a true arcade game. Picking up the checkered flags will cause the enemy cars to turn red. Like in Pac-Man, but unlike what checkered flags usually signify, the player's car can now ram into them and gain some points. It's unclear what this represents since the enemy car just vanishes to respawn elsewhere, but hey, raises your score. In the arcade version, the flag turns the enemy cars into money bags identical to those the player is supposed to collect. I'm not sure what that's supposed to represent either, but at least it better cues the player in to the new ability to eat the competition Pac-Man style. After each of the first five levels, the secret letter appears. Ooh. They seem to spell turbo backward. Deep lore. Speaking of lore, the original Route 16 is a mixture of several older arcade games. Of course, navigating an enemy-filled maze where you must collect all the items to reach the exit originates with head-on!
Applied directly to the forehead.
The 1979 Sega arcade game designed by Lane Hauk. It must have inspired Iwatani Toru when he was designing Pac-Man. Someone at Sega realized it too, as the company released a sequel under the title Pack Car on the SG-1000 in 1983. Like Route 16, Head-On and Packar feature the strategic use of turbo boosts to avoid an enemy car attempting to crash into you. The greater freedom of movement in Route 16 originates with Ito Hirohito and Kurosu Kazuo's 1980 arcade game, Rally X. And sure, gathering power-ups in a maze to consume your opponents comes from Pac-Man. This monster looks particularly Pac-Man-like. The other indisputable influence is the U.S. Air Force veteran Howell Ivey's 1982 arcade game, Venture, one of the earliest top-down dungeon crawlers. The player controls a chipper archer named Winky, who navigates a series of rooms to collect treasure. Grab every treasure and you win the level. Eat your heart out, Link. Every dungeon room has at least one exit, and when the player enters the dungeon hallways, the camera zooms out. These rooms are more interesting than the routes of Route 16, since each room has a unique name, theme, and enemies. Still, swapping out a greedy fantasy adventurer for a driver, also greedy, makes a substantial difference. Imagine if a developer copied The Legend of Zelda, except the player controls a car. More than a copycat, it would be a bold new vision. The original Route 16 and Venture both pause the game momentarily when you leave a room, allowing you to reorient yourself to the new perspective. Route 16 Turbo removes this pause, keeping up a fast pace, but potentially leading to a lost life if you don't catch your new position on the screen quickly enough. This is the only definite shortcoming of the remake. Now to address the nagging question, what is going on? None of the environments resemble anything real or show signs of human life. The cars and treasures seem uncanny, recognizable objects having no place in this alien world. Since the driver has to collect sacks of money, I conjecture that Route 16 Turbo depicts some kind of deadly game show with fabulous prizes. Further evidence that this is a corporate-sponsored event is the appearance of the name Sunsoft in certain routes. This could be a commentary on human greed, throwing these drivers' lives away for amusement in a ferocious scramble over literal sacks of cash is a parody of the rat race, the atomizing competition that Marx called the war amongst the greedy. The American arcade release's flyer boasts the tagline, "Money, the route of all evil." Clearly, this is serious social commentary. Also, this guy kind of freaks me out. Imagine him opening his mouth all the way. The presence of multiple swastika routes suggests this sporting event is eminently fascist, the outcome of the failing capitalist system. So, like Paris-Dakar Rally Special, Route 16 Turbo might depict a death race-like dystopian scenario. Coincidentally, Howell Ivey is also responsible for the 1976 video game Death Race, basically an unauthorized adaptation of the movie. While this reading makes sense, I don't think it quite explains everything. When vulnerable and collected, the opponents simply vanish. There aren't even floating eyes that zoom back to their house, like in Pac-Man, or an animation suggesting that they've exploded. Not only computer-controlled, the enemy cars are probably holograms, easy to turn off and turn back on. Route 16 Turbo depicts a virtual space. How else do we account for vanishing enemy cars, or money bags that transform into oil slicks and bombs and then back? Of course, it could be that we're controlling a driver in the grip of extreme hallucinations. Route 16 Turbo has no ending. The contestant can only lose. The cars are all remote-controlled or digital, so nobody's getting hurt. Why else would you enter a competition you can't win? But that's like explaining the events portrayed by saying, "It's a video game." Which mean, yeah. As for the swastikas, well, they're Buddhist symbols to tell the contestants good luck.
The swastika, Stu, far from being a symbol of Nazism, is in fact a Hindu good luck charm. And I always think, well, good luck with that.
Even The Legend of Zelda's third dungeon is a swastika. As a palate cleanser, this route is shaped like a heart. This route is made of smaller hearts. This one is an umbrella. Splish splash. This one is shaped like nothing, but it looks meaningful somehow anyway, like a pattern you'd see on an ancient textile. A glitch ends Route 16 Turbo at level 9, as collecting all the items won't end the level, but hackers have been able to reach level 10 and beyond. Developers release unfinished and broken video games today, but Route 16 Turbo proves that's nothing new, even in the days before developers could patch their broken software. Sunsoft later created high-quality titles like Blaster Master, but everyone starts somewhere. As for the other developer, Tekken, in 1987 the company merged with Tecmo. In 1985, when most developers and consumers knew arcade games well, and had no expectation that a home console game should be much different, most Famicom games were simple arcade-style titles like Route 16 Turbo. While I can imagine paying full price for, let's say, God Slayer, a high-quality, hours-long adventure in a new world with twists and turns, I don't know how anyone ever paid full price for arcade-style games like Route 16 Turbo. You might reasonably object that in 1985, this is what video games were. But you forget that in 1985, they already had books, and movies, and manga. So Route 16 Turbo is a minor title that slipped through the cracks. In that way, it's more representative of the majority of Famicom games than anything else in Famicom Adventures so far. Ho-ho! Driving those cars through mazes! What fun! You want more fun? Well, you can subscribe! You can subscribe to my channel! To Macrophones! And you can like the video, or you can follow me on Twitter at Macrophones and subscribe to my other channel, Macro Undercover! I'd appreciate it. Next time on Famicom Adventures, the third title I've looked at, from Namco.